Hello everyone. In today's CSAT Made Easy session, we are discussing the topic time and work. This is an important topic because about 7 questions have been asked in the past 8 years. So, on average, one question we can expect from the topic of time and work. Right. So, in the case of time and work, you need to know some basic concepts. What do you mean by time and what do you mean by work? See, whatever time we are allotting to complete a work, isn't it? We are allotting some time to complete some sort of work. So, in the case of time and work, what we assume is that work is always taken as one. If one is the work taken to do that one unit of work, how much time is required? That is a basic simple idea of time and work. There is one unit of work and how much time is required to complete that one unit of work, right? So, if work is one, for example, they are telling that work from how to calculate work from the number of days. If A can do a piece of work in n days, say I can do a piece of work in 20 days. 20 days means I can do what? I can complete a sort of work in 20 whole days. That means in one day, I already told you total work is taken as unity, right? So, in one day we will do 1 by 20th of the work. Okay. 1 by 20th of the work is completed per day. So, if 20 days is needed to complete a work, 1 by 20th will be done per day. That is the first case. Second case, they are telling I can do 1 by 30th of the work per day. That means what? Total how much duration I'll take 30 whole days to complete the work. Right. Here also. Here 1 by 20th per day means 20 whole days to complete the work. So that relation and its vice versa condition. That is what we need to keep in mind while doing the solving the problems of time and work. Right. So one more concept is that if A is thrice as good as a workman as B, this is a most important concept, one of the important concept which is usually repeating in the case of time and work. I am telling that Ram is thrice as efficient as Rohit. That means what? If Rohit does one unit of work, Ram will do 3 unit of work. Right. Then only he can say that he is thrice efficient. If he is making one pen per day or he is making one pen, he will make 3 pens. Right. So, the efficiency is written in the ratio 3:1. Right. If they are completing 3:1, the ratio of their time will be reverse. It will be 1:3. That is, work is inversely proportional to time. Right. Whenever work is inversely proportional to time. So, here they are doing this much work. He is doing this much work. So, he need only a little time to complete the work. His efficiency. Sorry, not work. Efficiency. Efficiency is inversely proportional to time. So, he is this much efficient means he need less time. Right. So, this is the basic idea with which we can move into the problems. The first question, this is somewhat logical question which can be answered with your basic idea of work and number of persons doing that work. Here, X men working at a constant speed can do a piece of work in Y days. Okay, let it be 10 men is there, they can do the work in 3 days. Okay. 10 men can do a complete work in 3 days. Which one of these relations shows, which one of the diagrams shows the actual relation? So, what happens if number of men are increasing? If 20 men is there, number of days will decrease, right? Whenever you build you are creating a building or you are building a home or your home, what will you do? When you are approaching the last date, final date, what will you do? You will increase the number of men. Why? So that you can finish it in lesser time, right? You can finish it at quickly, easily, isn't it? So that means if number of men increases, number of working days decreases. If 10 men can complete it in 30 days, 20 men will be able to complete it in 15 days. Right. So that is the relation. That means if number of men increases, working days decreases. So diagram 1 and diagram 4 are the conditions, are the diagrams which shows that decreasing trend. Right. In the diagram 2, what happens? If number of men is increasing, number of days is increasing. That is not true. Right. That is contradictory to this fact. So diagram 2 is not right. In diagram 3, they are telling that if according to that figure, at some point of time, for some value of x, that is for some number of men, the number of days is infinite. There are infinite values for a single point in the x coordinate, right? So that is not possible in the case of, that is not practically possible, right? So in such a case, this diagram 2 and diagram 3 can be rejected, and this diagram 1 can also be rejected. Why? Because for a value of x equal to 0, right, x equal to 0 means what? There is no men working. Still there is some y value, right? Y value means what? There is some working days. Without men, how this working days can come, right? This is also absolutely nonsense. So these three graphs cannot be used, and hence this fourth one, diagram 4, will be the answer which depicts the true relation between the number of men working and number of working days, right? So that is diagram 4 is the answer. And the next question, P works thrice as fast as Q. If Q makes 1 unit of work, P makes 3 units, right? We had already explained the condition of ratio, isn't it? Ratio of efficiencies. If Q is making 1 unit, P makes 3 units. Whereas P and Q together can work 4 times as fast as R. P and Q together makes 4 units when R makes 1 unit. Right. But we know when P and Q makes 4 units, 3 is made by P and 1 is made by Q. Right. P and Q makes 4 units when R makes 1 unit. That is the actual relation from that statement that P and Q works 4 times as fast as R. Right. So, but if they are making inside P and Q, if they are together making 4 units, 3 is made by P and Q is, 1 is made by Q from the first sentence. This is from the first condition. This is the second condition. Right. So, from these conditions, we can analyze that they are together making 4 plus 1, 5 units. Together they are making 4 plus 1, 5 units. Out of that, 1 is made by R, 1 is made by Q, and 3 is made by P. That means the ratio of their efficiencies is 3:1:1. If someone is most efficient, what will you give? You will give more salary or more earnings to him, right? One who is working well will earn more. So earnings will be also in the same ratio, 3:1:1. That is option A is the answer. Understood? So we will move on to the next one. Two pipes A and B can independently fill the tank in 20 minutes and 30 minutes. So 20 minutes and 30 minutes, A is there, B is there. A takes 20 minutes, B takes 30 minutes, right? So A will do 1/20th of the tank in per minute, isn't it? We already explained. B will fill 1/30th of the tank per minute, right? So this is the amount of water filled by A in a minute this is the amount of water filled by pipe B in a minute. So together they will make what? 1 by 20 plus 1 by 30, that is 30 by 20 by 600, that is 50 by 600, that is 1 by 12, isn't it? So here we are using that vice versa condition. In the very first slide of basic concepts, we had made, if B, A and B can together fill 1 by 12th of the tank per minute, isn't it? That means what? That means A and B requires 12 minutes to completely fill the tank. So this is the basic idea. In the very first slide of basic concept, we had explained the concept of taking 1 by 20 and 1 by 30. I hope you have understood clearly with the concept. If 1 is the unit, 1 by 20 will be 1 by 20th of the tank. 1 by 30th of the tank will be filled by A and B respectively. So A and B together will fill this much per minute. That means 12 minutes is required to fill the tank for A and B together. So with that, we are moving into the next question. This is a very easy question. You just need to know what you mean by percentage. This idea of percentage is already explained in the previous lecture. So I hope you will be able to do this very easily. W can do 25% of a work in 30 days, right? 25% of work in 30 days. So 100%, that is full work, is done in what? 13 into 4, 120 days, right? This is into 400, 25 into 400. So 30 into 4, 120, right? So W takes 120 days to complete the work. X can do 1/3 of the work in 10 days. 1/3 in 10 days. 1/3 of the X in 10 days. That means X equal to 30. It will take 30 days to completely do the work. Who? X. X need 30 days to complete the work. Y can do 40% of the work in 40 days. For Y, 40% of the work in 40 days. Right. That means 40 by 100 of X in 40 days. That is Y need 100, X equal to 100. So 100 days is needed for Y. Right. Which is the next condition? Z can do 1/3 of the work in 39 days. So, Z can do 1/3 of work in 13 days. So, the entire work in 13 into 3, 39 days. Right. So, these datas, if you can complete these datas, is very easily you can find out. What is the question? Who will complete the work first? Right. Who will complete the work first? X. X needs only 30 days to complete the work, right? Next comes Z, who need 39 days. Next comes Y, who need 100 days. And the poor W needs 120 whole days to complete the work, right? So X is the quicker one while completing the work. So option B is the answer. We'll move on to the next one. Ram and Shyam work on a job together for 4 days and complete 60% of it. So 60% of the work is completed in 4 days. So 100% to complete in how much mean? Let it be X. 3 by 5. X equal to 20 by 3. So Ram and Shyam need 20 by 3 days to complete the work. Right. If they need 20 by 3 days to complete the work, what is their 1 day's work? 1 day, 1 by 20 by 3. Isn't it? 1 by 20 by 3 work per day. Right. That means 3 by 20th of the work per day is completed by who? Ram and Shyam. Next condition. Ram takes the leave then and Shyam works for 8 more days to complete the job. Isn't it? So, 8 more days to complete the job. Which job? The actual job. But out of the actual job, 60% is already completed. Right. So, what remains? 40% remains. Right. So, to complete that 40% of the work, he needs 8 days. So, 40% of the work, 8 days. So, 100% of the work, x days. What? 5. So, x equal to 20. 20 days is needed for who? Shyam, right? Shyam needs 20 days. That means, Shyam can do 1 by 20th of the work per day. Right? Ram and Shyam together can do 3 by 20th of the work per day. Shyam can do 1 by 20th of the work per day. Right? So, what is the... So, we need to calculate how, in what time Ram can complete the work. So, 1 day, if we are taking 1 day's work, 1 day's work of Ram plus Shyam equal to, Ram's is unknown, right? Equal to x plus 1 by 20. Isn't it? This is the 1 day work of Ram plus Shyam. Let it be x, Ram's. This is the same as 3 by 20. Right? Together done by Ram and Shyam. So, what do you mean by x? X equal to 3 by 20 minus 1 by 20 equal to 2 by 20 equal to 10 days. Right? So, 10 days is this 1 by 10. 1 by 10th of the work is completed in, is completed by Ram. So, Ram takes 10 days to complete the work. Okay. I'll tell once again, 60% of the work was completed by Ram and Shyam together, right, in 4 days. 60% in 4 days means we will use the ratio and proportion method. 60% 4 days. So, 100% x days. We found out that x. 20 by 3 days is needed. 20 by 3 days is needed to complete the work. So, 1 by 20 by 3 is the 1 day's work. So, taking the ratio, 3 by 20th work is completed in day per day by Ram and Shyam. Right. And again, remaining 60 is already gone. Remaining 40 is completed in 8 days. So, 100% complete in x days. This x is found to be 20 days. That means, Shyam takes 20 days to complete the whole work, which was earlier done by, which could have been done by Ram and Shyam in 20 by 3 days. Ram, Shyam alone will take 20 days. So, that means 1 day's work is 1 by 20. So, 1 day's work of Ram and Shyam is 3 by 20. Shyam is 1 by 20. Difference is 2 by 20. That is 1 by 10. 1 by 10 is the 1 day's work of Ram. So, Ram will take total 10 days to complete the work. Right. So, we will move on to the next one. A lift has the capacity of 18 adults and or 30 children. Right. So, they are taking, considering the weight of those persons. A lift can carry either 18 adults or 30 children. Isn't it? So, the capacity of the lift is the same. 18 adults weight. That means, weight of the 18 adults is the same as that of the 30 children. So, weight of 18 adults equal to 30 children. Right? That means, we are cutting it. 3a equal to 5c, cutting by 6, right? 3 adult equal to 5 children. Already how many adults are there in the lift? 12 adults are there. So, into 4, into 4. 12 adults are there, that means 20 children. 12 adults is equivalent to 20 children. So, the weight equivalent of 20 children is already there in the lift. Right, 20 children is already there in the lift. So, how many more can be afforded? Total is 30, already 20, remaining 10 children can be afforded more in the lift along with those 12 adults. Right, this equivalency is the concept. Capacity of the lift is the same. So, the weight of the 18 adults equal to weight of the 30 children. So, we made a ratio of adults and children. From that, if we found the corresponding ratio of 12 adults in respect to children, with respect to the number of children. Thus, we found out the answer. So, we are moving into the next one. In a garrison, where there was food for 1000 soldiers, there was food for 1000 soldiers for 30 days. 1 month means 30 days, right? There was food for, this much food was there in that garrison already, isn't it? But after 10 days, what happens? 1000 into 10 amount will be used out. Isn't it? This is initial. Isn't it? This is after 10 days. After 10 days, this much amount will be used. Isn't it? So, what remains? This minus, this is what remains. Right. So, that is 1000 into 30 minus 10, 20 remains. This is the new quantity of food currently. But after 10 days, something happened. What happens? 1000 more soldiers joined the garrison. Right. 1000 more soldiers means 1000 plus 1000, 2000 soldiers is already there. They can survive how many days? We need to find out. This is the total quantity. This is the required quantity. Right. So, cancelling, this is 10 days. With that much soldiers, they can survive only 10 more days. So, with this, we are winding up the session of time and work. Time and work problems are somewhat simple. As such, is very simple. You just need to understand the concept of time and work. How to put the time and work. Work we are assumed as one unity, and with respect to that unit amount of work, we are assuming the time. So, if you are practicing, you will be able to solve these questions very easily. So, I hope you can do well. Thank you.